Hey guys, welcome to Weight Loss Wednesday, and it's a pretty exciting Wednesday. I know I shared this information on my Facebook page yesterday to all of my like TTC mommy community people that are part of my Facebook, but I heard back from my insurance yesterday. I got approved. So my doctor's office, actually my case manager at United Healthcare, who I've been working with this entire time, that is absolutely phenomenal. I mean, this entire time since January, she called me and she said, I just got done looking over your file. You're approved. You're great to go. I am going to call your surgeon's office, let them know, and expect a call from them shortly to schedule your surgery. My chest gets tight because I get like excited. So they called me yesterday, my case manager at my surgeon's office, which is Rockwood Clinic Bariatric Surgery, and I'm going with Dr. Bright because they have several doctors there, and that's in Spokane, Washington. She called me and she was like, you know, your insurance approved you and we have you down for surgery. The next appointment available is May 5th. Cinco de Mayo. They actually had one that was sooner. It would have been April 22nd, but I would have had to have already started my 2-week post-op stuff. So she was like, so that's too soon. It won't work. Excuse me. And she said, plus you need to still come in and meet with the nutritionist. So Cinco de Mayo is the day. My check-in is at 7:45 in the morning. Surgery scheduled for 9. And so that's kind of crazy. And then what else? And then I have my nutritionist appointment on the 22nd, which is still a day into my 2-week post-op diet. So she's sending me kind of a packet on what to start. And then if I have any questions, or I'll go over it more with the nutritionist when I see her on the 22nd. But I'm supposed to start my 2-week post-op stuff. Excuse me, 2-week post-op stuff on the 21st. So that's kind of crazy because that's in like a week, 2 weeks. Let me see. I think it's 2 weeks because today's the 9th. So yeah, 2 weeks. So I have, it would have been 4 weeks from last Monday. So I have like 3.5 weeks and then I will be getting sleeved. Oh my gosh. So the night that I found out, I called my husband and he came home and he had a couple of goodies. He just like went to Walmart and was like, you know, here you go, congratulations. It was really sweet and nothing like I didn't think of. I haven't gone shopping yet because like I said, I just got the approval yesterday, and so I will be going shopping this weekend to get all my protein shakes and all that fun stuff. But I want to show you what he got me because it's like so stupid, but it's so cute. So he was like, I know you're going to be doing a lot of, you know, you have to eat a lot of broths and stuff like that and soups for 2 weeks. He was like, and we already have like, because we already kind of stocked up on chicken broth and beef broth. He was like, but look at what I found you. It's Mexican tortilla broth. So it's 100% natural Mexican tortilla flavor infused broth. So there's no chunks, nothing. It's purely liquid. So I was like, that's kind of cool. I've never seen this before. So he got me that, which it's so random, but it was so cute. He got me some measuring cups and spoons these are all my own. So the kids know, you know, these are mommy's and they're all held together on this nice ring. So it won't be hard to like lose them or anything like that. Cause we have some nice ones now, like some measuring cups, but they're like ceramic. So those ones are pretty nice. And then he bought me this is a Contigo. Yeah, it's a Contigo water thing. And it's basically a one-handed drinking. It's non-spill. So like if I leave this out on the table, the kids won't like drip it or spill it or anything like that. And they do have insulated ones. My husband has a Contigo coffee bottle that we got from Costco, and they're amazing. So he got me this, and you have to push it to open it. The button's right here. So you push it to open it, so it's easy to sip. Like, it's not a super big mouth. It's pretty small. So this will be great. And it's 24 ounces, so I'll be drinking 3 of these, and that actually puts me over my 64 ounces. So 3 of these a day will be my goal. So that's all that I have. Like I said, I haven't gone shopping for anything else. I have started myself like a list of just different things, and so yeah, it's happening. I will share with you my weight. My weight as of today is 227.8 pounds. I have been using my mother-in-law scale, but she's moved out, so I only use it whenever I go over there. And I don't know, to be honest, if I want to buy a scale or if I still want to just use her scale, because I'm afraid I will like weigh myself every single day. But that is kind of on my list of things to get. So I have a food scale, a regular scale, I want one of those mixer bottles that has like the little ball in it for my protein shakes. I'm going to get the Fitbit wristbands that you see everybody wearing. Costco had them, so me and my husband went and looked at those yesterday. It's kind of a cool, it's an app that you use on your phone, and it's to track all your intake. It tracks your how many steps you took, how often you got up at night, which is going to be hilarious because I am still a mother of a one-year-old. So, yeah, I've got quite a big list of things, of like vitamins, but I'm sure my bariatric nutritionist will go over all that with me. So I don't know if I will buy my vitamins beforehand, or I'll wait until she talks to me, because I do take vitamin D3, calcium, citrate, chewables, and vitamin D3, calcium, magnesium, and a multivitamin every day anyways. But they say some of them are more beneficial for bariatric patients. So I'm not sure which brand she prefers. So that's kind of what we will do for that. And then I did make a list this morning of NSVs, which stands for non-scale victories. So it's kind of little stepping stones through this surgery, or afterwards, little victories that you'll hit that you know you want to hit. So I'm on my laptop now, and I wanted to share those with you. I think I made 13 of them. My goal was to get 10, and like the first, like I got to like 7, and I'm like, I'm stuck. So it's funny, after I got stuck, I was like, oh, and that one, and that one, and that one, and that one, and that one. So I will share with you those. So number one NSV is have Robert, my husband, pick me up with ease. He can pick me up. He's a strong guy. But, like, his face turns red, and he can only, like, lift me up. And I know it might be weird, but I want him to, like, lift me up. Like, pick me up, you know, and, like, manhandle me kind of thing. Because he hasn't been able to do that. Just being honest. Number two is no chub rub. That's where your thighs meet, and they rub. And believe it or not, I blow out so many pants in the crotch area from like rubbing the like material raw. So I have big thighs. So no chub rub. Number three is shop at normal stores. I shop mostly at Old Navy right now just because their clothes are like bigger sizes. So I would like to go shop at Forever 21 or, you know, any store basically in the mall. Any store in the mall, because like I'm limited to like Torrid right now, like plus size stores. So yeah, shop at normal stores. Number four would be no double chin. I don't remember the last time I have not had a double chin. Number five is run 2 miles without stopping. I haven't been able to do that since like my junior year in high school. So really work up my lungs, work up, you know, my capacity to run 2 miles without stopping. I'm not saying those 2 miles have to be run fast. I'm just saying that they need to be ran. Number six, be a size 9. A size 9 is the smallest I can remember me wearing in high school. So I would like, that's my goal. I'd like to be like a size 9 pants. Number seven is be able to do lunges without pain. I have horrid knees right now. They crunch. Well, you've probably seen my videos. So to have the weight off to where it's no longer affecting my knees would be great. So to do lunges without pain. Number eight, be comfortable wearing just a bathing suit. I can wear a bathing suit now, but I wear jeans and a tank top and a cover up. So be comfortable wearing a bathing suit, no cover up, no shorts. That would be awesome. It does not have to be a bikini, just a bathing suit. Number nine, wear a loose fitting shirt that I do not look pregnant in. I'm so big breasted right now, and I know that that's one thing that I'm going to need surgery on later, because right now I think I'm a 42 double D. So I would like to wear a shirt that is loose that I don't look pregnant in. Number 10 is wear boots that fit over my calves. I love dress suits. I think they are so freaking cute with like skinny jeans. I have one pair right now, and it's because the bands of them are elastic and they were like made for bigger girls. So I'd like to be able to go like to Kohl's and get like any boot that I think, I was like, oh, that's a cute boot, and buy it and know that it'll fit my calf. Number 11, no longer be considered in the obese category. That one pretty much speaks for itself. Number 12, feel feminine. I have always, I've never been able to like feel feminine because a lot of the clothes that you wear are just so big and so bulky, and if they are like cute and fitted, my cha-chas are hanging out for everyone to see. So it's really hard for me to like feel petite and feel feminine. Number 13, be able to cross my legs. I can cross them at the ankles, but like actually like cross them, I don't remember the last time I did that. And number 14 is enjoy seeing my reflection when I go out. I know that is a weird, weird thing to think about, but I will get ready at home. I will do my hair. I will do my makeup. I will get dressed. And I'm like, oh, I'm pretty cute. And then for some reason, when you go outside and there's like other people, your reflection, like I'm like, I look like shit. Or I look really bad. So to like go out and see my reflection and be like, oh, I still look cute. You know what I mean? Or I still look good. Or my outfit is still cute. Or, hey, I don't look like a blimp. Or, wow, am I really that fat? You know what I mean? Like, I would love to see my reflection and be like, oh, okay, I like it. Not too much to ask. So, yeah. It's soon. It's like 3.5 weeks away. So I'm going to probably do, I know Weight Loss Wednesdays right now are just specifically for weight loss things, goals, NSVs. But I will do probably more on my weight loss when it comes to like my 2-op or my 2-week pre-op diet. My doctor also said that it is 2 weeks of liquids. Like I know some doctor's offices only do a week of liquids, and then the other week is like a protein shake in the morning and then lean meat and veggies for lunch and dinner. No, my doctor's office is 2 weeks liquid. So I will be vlogging about how hungry I feel, how much it sucks to cook dinner for other people when you're still hungry, if I cheat, because I'm going to be honest. And I think I've already, I'm going to ask my nutrition about this, but I love miso soup, which miso soup is an Asian soup and it's got chunks of tofu in it. And I like the silken tofu, which is really, it's really soft. So I can literally mush it up in my mouth. So I have to see if that's going to be okay for me to eat. Because if so, I will have that all the day because I love miso soup. So yeah, I will let you guys know what's going on next Wednesday. And I'll probably keep everything I buy over the weekend for VSG and weight loss orientated like stuff. I'll probably keep that and then show you guys and do a haul on Wednesday. And then I will do my, then the one after that will be about my nutritionist appointment and my 2-week post-op. Pre-op. I keep saying post. Pre-op diet. Ah! So, yeah. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Talk to you later.